Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now, it can be so many things that have been done. Sometimes the people were taken to witch doctors and they were cut, dust was poured inside. Sometimes they gave you something to lick. Sometimes you're given some thread to tie around your waist. Sometimes you are given a necklace or some plant to go and plant in your home. Those are altars, and they will demand to operate. An altar must function. An altar must operate. An altar must be felt. An altar must be given attention. An altar must be esteemed. And so, I want to pray with you. Maybe you are young, you are taken ignorantly, you are given a cloth to put on, and today it comes back to follow you. It comes back to disturb you, to haunt you, the spirits of the altars of witchcraft. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 54, verse 6, verse 14. Let me start from 14. The Bible says, "You will be reestablished when I vindicate you. You will not experience oppression. Indeed, you will not be afraid. You will not be terrified, for nothing frightening will come near you. If anyone dares to challenge you, it will not be my doing." God is saying, if anyone dares to challenge you, it will not be his doing. Whoever tries to challenge you will be defeated. Anyone who dares and tries to challenge you, the Bible says he will be defeated. Verse 16, the word of God records, "Look, I create the craftsman who fans the coals into a fire and forges a weapon. I'm the one who creates that magician who prepares charm." You know, God hits his chairs, he thumbs his chairs, and he says, "I am the one. I'm the one who has created even those people who have manufactured things to kill others, things to destroy other people." Verse 16, "But B, I create the destroyer who takes to devastate. No weapon fought to be used against you will succeed. You will refute everyone who tries to accuse you. This is what the Lord will do for his servants, says the Lord." Child of God, I want you to know. I want you to understand. The Bible says no weapon forged against you, no weapon fashioned against you, no weapon prepared against you, the Bible says, shall prosper. Why? It is because the Lord has prepared a heritage for us that is fighting our battles. Another translation says, surely they will gather against you. Another one says, surely they will conspire against you, but they are not from me. And he says, because I'm the one who has created the magicians, I'm the one who has created these people, who prepared these things even to put them to action. And he says, no weapon. Him who said no weapon fought against you shall prosper is the same God. It does not change. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's faithful. And so I want to pray with you based on the word of God. I want to pray with you, even if it is an altar that was erected before you were born. Jesus. And I want to tell you, prayer is powerful. It can go into the future. It can move back into the past. And it can make corrections of things that were not correctly made. I want to pray with you. I want to, even if it was done to you ignorantly, you did it intentionally, you did it when you were aware, God is able to do it. God is able to do it. God is able to do it. God is able to break the bondage. He's able to destroy the shackle. He's able to destroy and to bring down that altar that was erected in your family, that was erected in your marriage, that was erected in the lives of your children, that was erected in your studies, that was erected in your business, that was planted in your affairs. That altar is, God can break it down. God can pull it. This is why Jesus went to the cross to destroy the work of the devil. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 7, the Bible says, "For this reason, the Son of God was manifested to destroy the work of the devil." Witchcraft is the work of the devil. Wizardry is the work of the devil. Magic and magicians do the work of the devil. Sorcery and sorcerers, it is the work of the devil. Cards and occultism, they are the works of the devil. But God has given us power. The Bible says in Corinthians that for the weapons of our warfare spiritual, they are not carnal. They are mighty through God, used in the pulling down of strongholds and subjecting into the authority every thought that raises itself against the will of the Father. So today, I want you just to hold your chest as I'll be praying with you. Repeat after me. Just hold your chest and repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I repent of all my sins that I did by intention and out of intention. I've had your word and I surrender to your Lordship today. Dear Jesus, forgive me, sanctify me, wash me with your precious blood, vindicate me, show up for my case, ensnare me, unfetter me, unshackle me, unchain me, get me scot-free from all altars, from all pillars of darkness. Wash me, cleanse me, consecrate me, make me your child for your own glory. Thank you, Jesus, for walking into my heart and into my life. Start afresh with me and cause me to live a new life in Jesus' name. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, I give you praise, I bless you, I give you glory, I give you honor. The Bible says that the thief cometh to steal, kill, and destroy, but you came to give life and to give life in abundance in John chapter 10, verse 10. O God of grace, dismantle and bring down all forces of oppression, all kingdoms of darkness, every altar of magicians, of wizards, of sorcery, and witchcraft. I pull you down by this anointing. The Bible says anointing breaketh yokes. Under this anointing, I break yokes. Yokes that follow these children of God. Yokes that follow their families, marriages, businesses, homes, lives, and lifestyles. I break them down in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, vindicate them, show up for them, and be glorified in all their affairs. Heal them, restore them, because you are a God of restoration. Renew them, transform them, uplift them, and give them hope again. I give you praise, I give you glory for what you are doing and what you've already done. For in this simple manner, breaking yokes of the devil. I worship you, Lord. I give you praise. I esteem you. I give you glory for what you are doing and what you've already done. May you receive all the praise and adoration, because you are a good and a merciful and a faithful and gracious God. Receive all the glory and adoration for what you have done. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen. God bless you and shalom.